After 4 weeks of a strict lockdown to curb the spread of the coronavirus, Germany eased some of its restrictive measures, allowing some shops to reopen this week in cities such as Cologne and Frankfurt. Across the Atlantic in the U.S., there have been protests at state capitals against individual state lockdowns by groups largely supportive of President Trump. But in Florida, some beaches have reopened. And in the state of Georgia, fitness clubs and hair salons will start opening their doors later this week. Health experts warn that Germany and South Korea have widespread testing, decreasing hospitalizations, and lowering death rates per capita that allow for easing of the lockdown. The U.S., now the epicenter of the coronavirus pandemic, is not there yet.
We need to expand testing capacity so that basically what the administration promised, everyone who wants a test can get a test. And when we think about that, what that data would then show us is if we started to see peaks in new transmissions, we would catch that more quickly. Right now, we are only testing people with symptoms, and we know that people begin to transmit prior to symptoms.
You would hope even a reduction over a 14-day period, and then you would have to make sure that the hospitals are capable of taking care of those patients.
In New York City and other parts of the U.S., healthcare workers are protesting the lack of personal protective equipment to keep them safe as they work to save others.
In many settings, in many hospitals, we've seen astoundingly high rates of infection amongst health workers. That is a catastrophe. I would argue that's a moral disgrace.
Experts caution that easing lockdown restrictions will be a delicate dance, and that restrictions may need to be reimposed if coronavirus cases spike again. Cindy Sain, VOA News.